Senator from Texas.
Mr. President, I'd like to begin by thanking our friend and colleague from Iowa, Senator Ernst, for her leadership on the reauthorization. And indeed, I think the important point should be made to strengthen the Violence Against Women Act. We don't have to settle for the House bill. We can have a better bill for victims of domestic violence. But unfortunately, like so much important work, we seem to constantly get diverted and distracted and dragged down by the partisanship that seems to dominate in Washington, D.C. these days. For many months, our colleague from Iowa has been working closely with Senator Feinstein, the senator from California, to try to figure a way to reauthorize this critical law. In the meantime, though, not on one occasion, but on two occasions, we have offered a continuing resolution that would extend the current reauthorization, and our Democratic colleagues have shut that down. And so we are in an uncharted territory where we don't currently have an authorization for the Violence Against Women Act. So I share our colleagues' disappointment when our Democratic colleagues walked away from the negotiating table and chose to introduce a replica of the House's partisan bill, which, as you've heard, does not have the support to pass in the Senate. Let me say one thing that should be abundantly clear, but sometimes I think it gets lost. We all agree that more must be done to prevent violence and respond to it. It's fair to say we have different opinions on what those pathways look like. But one thing should not be up for debate. Whether or not we reauthorize the Violence Against Women Act, that is something we need to do. But the fact is we don't have to settle for the House bill. We can do better. Our Democratic colleagues took an interesting approach in introducing a bill that a majority of people in this chamber will not support, and they know that. Sadly, that's part of the point. They know they have a bill that does not enjoy consensus support because they'd rather make the political point, an argument that somehow some of us on this side don't believe in supporting victims of domestic violence, which is absolutely a falsehood. It's a lie. During a press conference, the senator from Hawaii even conceded five times that the House bill is going nowhere. But that's the path our Democratic colleagues have chosen. Rather than work in a bipartisan fashion to build a consensus package that can actually become law, they decided to head down a partisan path led by the House bill, which came to us 7 months ago. So clearly, some of our colleagues here in the Senate are not interested in actually making laws. They're in it for the headlines, for the politics. So in the face of this ridiculous and unacceptable jockeying, I'm glad that today Senator Ernst will introduce a consensus alternative to the bill offered by our colleagues, and I'm proud to be a co-sponsor of the legislation. This bill, introduced by the senator from Iowa, will send more funding and more resources to the Violence Against Women Act than the Democrat bill. It's actually better, and it will authorize the program for twice as long. It'll give the Department of Justice the stability needed to plan for the future without being jerked around by partisan games. But this bill includes a lot more than just funding. It also addresses a number of horrific crimes that are being committed against women and girls in our country. Sex trafficking, for example, is currently not always recognized as a form of sexual assault, and it is. But this bill would make that clear. It would also enhance the maximum criminal penalties for sexual abuse of minors and other vulnerable groups. It will, as you heard, take aim at heinous crimes like mutilation and address crimes in rural areas and on tribal lands. This legislation includes provisions from a number of bipartisan bills that have been introduced in the Senate to both improve resources for victims and target specific types of abuse. One example is a bill I introduced with the senator from California, my friend Senator Feinstein, called the HEALS Act, that would remove some of the hurdles that exist between victims of domestic violence and their access to safe housing. That's in our bill. This provision would also include greater flexibility for transitional housing programs so that survivors can get back on their feet without the fear of losing the roof over their head. This bill includes language introduced by Senators Murkowski and Cortez Masto to combat the epidemic of murdered and missing Native women and girls. It will allow for better law enforcement coordination and provide local and tribal law enforcement with more resources to address these crimes. It's critical that we all call attention to these despicable acts of violence and unequivocally reject them without regard to partisanship or party. Another challenge we face is technology outpacing our ability to counter certain types of exploitation. Abusive images and videos proliferate online, for example. This is a relatively new challenge, but it's real and it's omnipresent. This legislation will empower victims of this type of abuse to remove the content from the internet by using copyright takedown authority. It also establishes an innovation fund for the Office on Violence Against Women to address emerging trends so victims get the support they need as quickly as possible. So if you compare this legislation to the bill passing the House and introduced by our Democratic colleagues here, there is no question our version does more to support survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault. It provides more funding over a longer period of time, and it targets despicable crimes that are being committed across the country that aren't even covered by the House bill. So let me just close and thank our friend from Iowa for continuing to fight for victims of domestic violence and sexual assault and for leading the effort to reauthorize the Violence Against Women Act, a bill that never should have been lapsed despite two attempts to continue it that our Democratic colleagues objected to. I'm proud to be a co-sponsor of this bill and look forward to working with all of our colleagues to advance it. So I hope our colleagues will return to the negotiation table and work with us so we can send a long-term reauthorization of the Violence Against Women Act to the President's desk for his signature.